actually, the first year that I came to Webit was, I think it was 4 years ago. And it was a very wild thing back then to ask the organization to fund and to actually send me to this event, because it wasn't very common for us to go to events like this. And back then, we didn't really participate as we didn't have any speakers. We didn't really participate on the agenda. And for us as employees, it was really interesting to see so many people have this conversation, and we said we want to be part of it. So every year since then, we've been part of the Webit Festival. We've been coming here. We've had you as a speaker. This is your second year representing Bayer and G4A. And so for us, it means a lot to be part of this conversation.
And you know, this morning I talked about how we're trying to change the inside as the outside is adapting so much quicker. And you know, for a good reason, there are processes in place, but how do we speed a lot of that up? And I'd love to kind of understand, I mean, yeah, you got involved with kind of the G4A family. There's a number of initiatives around innovation going on. You know, I met you last year, and that kind of passion just exuded. It was obvious.
Yeah.
But maybe talk a little bit through that journey. How do you convince people around the organization, and maybe some experiences that you've had already in the last year or two?
Well, I mean, it's tough. It's tough because we're sitting here, all of us today, and we have a pretty similar mindset. We believe that in the future of healthcare, digital plays a massive role, that we need to kind of mind the gap between the healthcare organizations, the pharmaceutical companies, and also the government, and as well the tech industry. And we all agree on that, but you have to understand that in massive organizations like ours, we have people that work for over 35 years there, and for them, they kind of get stuck in this loop where they go to work every day in the same office, they meet the same peers, they very fixed in what they have to do and what their tasks are. And when you come to them and you say, okay, but we need to be quick now, we need to act very fast, we need to be agile, we need to learn about innovation, we need to go to events like this and speak to startups, they kind of get a bit shocked. But with time, the more people we got engaged and the more people we identified in our organization that are actually very passionate about innovation and healthcare coming to the next level, you know, it kind of starts piling up. We did a program last year with our employees that basically what we wanted to do is give them the opportunity to learn a bit more about the startup culture. So we engaged with one of the biggest co-working spaces in Sofia. We rented a desk there and we said, you have one day every week for the next 3 months to go to this place, to talk to these people, and to work on your own idea and project following the business model canvas and kind of really de-risking your concept and your idea. Because we also get that a lot, you know, from people saying, we have great ideas, we have so many great ideas, we just need the funding. But you also need to fight internally to get the funding. You need to be convincing.
You know, it's interesting. I remember when I first arrived 3 years ago, and we have this ideation platform internally. And I actually was on at midnight or 2 a.m. reading some of those submissions, and I was actually reaching out to people and saying, great idea, would you be willing to spend more time after work or on weekends to actually pursue it? And the crazy part is actually 7 out of 10 kind of said, no, I just thought it was an interesting idea, right? And so it does take actually extracting yourself from the building, from the mindset, and actually pursuing some of that.
Exactly. The two biggest challenges that we had with this program were, A, the time. Even with the support of our leadership team, which are, by the way, great people, very, very, you know, into the mindset that we're talking about here. Even with that support for the employees, it was difficult to find the time to really push themselves to go out of the comfort zone, to go from a place where you're been constantly told don't risk too much, you know, think twice before you act, to a totally different place where you tell everybody just go ahead, take a risk, take a chance, test your assumptions, go back, redefine your problem, speak to people, and just be out there and act directly. That was the first big challenge. And the second one was the fear of failure, because in such a big organization like ours, it's sometimes difficult to take the stage and to say, okay, I have an idea. You know, it's not very good shaped. Then the business start asking a million questions. They want you to be prepared to pretty much sell it. Pretty much what's happening with the startups out there. Like, what is your plan? Did you already test it? Do you have proof of concept? You know, who's your team? How much time are you willing to invest in this? And it gets a bit overwhelming for them. They're not used to being in that position. And the risk of failure and being on that stage is, hey, this guy is doing something innovative, and what if I fail? Then, you know, where does that leave me?
You know, we tried an experiment last year around, especially in our commercial structure deal, where the G4A team seeded some of those relationships. We actually reversed it, and those business teams had to pitch back to us as well as external venture capital to actually win that funding. And we were actually turning it around and saying, what are you going to do with the startup? What are the milestones? What do you want to accomplish? By when? So I think, you know, champions like yourself, you know, I think startups outside look for champions like yourself. But we, kind of the innovators inside, also need the champions and the support and persistence.
And of course, we also need the global structure, right? So the fact that we have over 300 offices around the world, and by the way, like the top number of meetings that I've had in one day is 21 meetings, if you can imagine. Like sometimes the day starts very early at 6 o'clock because you need to speak to Japan, but that is a great opportunity for you to exchange. And also through the program that we did last year, one of the teams actually found out that there is already something like this being developed, and you know, across the Pacific. So this opportunity, this global structure, and the G4A program specifically, is a way for us to take something that we see here, you know, kind of see what it's all about, and then take it up there to people like you and to the executives over at Berlin.
Yeah, I also kind of, this reminded me, literally the first day I walked in, somebody said, if only Bayer knew what Bayer actually knows, right? I mean, it is 120,000 people, and there's a tremendous amount of innovators around the company, and it's actually connecting this. And one thing, we kind of started this, and to a certain extent started going viral. It's a bit of a rebels group. It's a WhatsApp group. It is Rebels with a Cause. So last year, I think we invited Biliana, but we have, you know, dozens upon dozens of people now that are saying, you know what? Yeah, things are fantastic. It's a great company, but this is where we want to see change. And this is around reverse mentoring. And we have, you know, a number of things that as a kind of rebel team or tribe, trying to push a lot of that back to that Oreo cookie example that I said. You have the bottoms-up layer. It needs to be capped with a top-down. So in... just to keep within the timing, any advice to the startups or other corporates that you've experienced locally, kind of final points from you?
I think that, you know, as corporate people, we should all, you know, kind of strip down the suits and just get out there. It's not such a scary place, and all it takes is, you know, the incentive for you to do so. There is a lot of things that you can learn, and there are a lot of things that you can teach also the startups. They can definitely use some help, and us as corporations, we have quite a lot of experience, we have quite a lot of know-how. Even just sharing and exchanging is already creating, you know, your small part into this ecosystem and making the small steps towards the final goal, which is actually having a better healthcare for people, having prevention instead of just only treating the disease, and, you know, having a better access for the patients to a better quality of life, because that's what we're all about at the end of the day.
That's a very good ending statement. So thank you for being so brave.
Thank you.